Tuesday, and it's 11 a.m., which means it's time for the FIU Music Hour on WDNA 88.9 FM, where we present live weekly performances in the WDNA Jazz Gallery and feature students, faculty, and alumni from Florida International University's Herbert and Nicole Wertheim School of Music and Performing Arts. I'm your host today, Ruben Sabando, and along with our producer, Dr. Rush Spiegel, and executive producer, Dr. Karen Veloz, we'd like to welcome you to our show. Whether you're listening to us at home, in your car, or live on wdna.org/FIU, we're delighted to have you with us. Here on WDNA, education plays a huge role. This is our last day of our fall membership drive, where we're playing the good music you love and asking for your support. Our FIU Music Hour goal is $1,000, so your donation matters today and every day. Donate online at wdna.org or give us a call during our office hours at 305-662-8889. We'd love to hear from you. Today, we're pleased to feature the FIU Jazz Faculty Ensemble, featuring Gary Campbell on saxophone, Michael Eckroth on piano, Jamie Owsley on bass, and Ludwig Alfonso on drums. Good morning, guys. What are the first pieces that we're going to hear today?
We're going to play a couple compositions by our saxophonist, Gary Campbell. This will be Cinema and Just For Now.
Okay.
Thank you.
Now we're going to go over to the interview with Professor Gary Campbell. Yeah. Okay, so
Hi.
Hi, how are you?
Good.
So I'm here with Professor Gary Campbell from the FIU Jazz Faculty Ensemble. Gary, can you tell us a little bit about the pieces that we just heard?
Yes, these are some pieces that I wrote some time ago. And excuse me,
yeah.
I forgot my mic here. I wrote these some time ago and had played them just a little bit on a few gigs, maybe 10 years ago, something like that. But never really got to record them or play any, you know, with these guys. So I got them out, brushed them off a little bit, dusted them off, and we started playing it. It's the first one, Cinema, is like kind of descriptive of a, I see it like as a motion picture, kind of a mood piece, if you will, atmospheric thing. And then the other one, then it segues into another piece, Just For Now, which was also, they're both older pieces, and revived it a little bit and made an arrangement here for this band, and it's fun to play.
Awesome. Well, it sounded wonderful. The next question that I have for you, I know you were very active in the 1960s in the New York loft scene.
Yeah.
Who were some of your earlier musical inspirations at that time?
Well, I mean, the same inspirations that all my colleagues when I got to New York, all the guys that were there, and John Coltrane, Sonny Rollins, Wayne Shorter, Joe Henderson, Stan Getz, all the great players affect you in some way. If they got something that's strong, then it affects you. And but then, of course, the discussion and all of the playing that was happening in the lofts was also a lot of free playing, free form playing that was influenced by, I guess you would call it the free jazz movement that happened in the late 50s and then through the 60s. And Ornette Coleman's band and Coltrane's later work and whatever was happening. There was a lot happening in New York in that regard. Studio Ribby, Sam Rivers had a loft where there were a lot of live performances. In people's lofts, Chick Corea's Trio, Circle, I think was the name of it, and a lot of things, and a lot of blowing with no predetermined formulas or anything.
Right.
Just start playing, and then hours later,
see where it
stop.
Goes.
Stop. Yeah. Right. At some point, but that the idea was just to experience, you know, with the sound,
right,
and all that. Maybe there was a pulse or rhythm or whatever, but maybe not. So it was fun,
right?
Which is an important thing when you're playing music.
Absolutely,
is to have fun.
I 100% agree.
A lot of influence or a lot of indulgence in that kind of a thing too, which is always good,
right,
for the soul and for the music as a result.
Yeah, and I think that definitely transfers over to every, you know, genre of music. It's important to really have that passion and just enjoy. A lot of times we, you know.
Oh yeah, it can get too, I hate to use the word serious, but you know, calculated and all that. I mean, because it's like your life. Sometimes things you figure are going to happen, other times you didn't think that was going to happen.
Yep.
Or surprises happen, good or bad, but it goes on, you know. And that's, the music is good to explore that. Plus, in every art form, there are phases. There's the classic phases, and then things like bebop, which became classic, and then the avant-garde. This happened in painting and everything, classical composition. All these phases go by, and new things are discovered, and that was a time when a lot of that was happening, especially in New York,
right,
which is the place, you know.
Very cultural center.
Oh, yeah.
And that kind of leads me into my next question. I know you worked a lot abroad in Europe and in Latin America. So the next question that I had for you was, did those experiences in these other countries influence the way that you perform or teach here in the United States?
Sure, yeah. Everything that you do in your musical experience In my mind, anyway, that's what I just teach from what I've experienced, you know, what I know and what I've learned. And that's about it. I don't try to make stuff up,
right?
You know, or follow a pedagogical framework necessarily. But those experiences were good, and especially in Europe, there were different people. I worked for a great bassist, Miroslav Vitus, for almost 15 years throughout Europe in recording. I think I'm on 4 or 5 of his recordings.
Wow.
And a few of those were live, and that was a very interesting band. And great venues and all that. And it was wonderful. It was like the late 60s, early 70s in New York, kind of, you know. Because that was from the early 2000s through, I think the last gig was 2016, maybe.
Oh, wow, fairly recently.
So
awesome.
That was all great, yeah.
So I think we've got about time for one more piece before we head into our break. So why don't you introduce what we're going to be hearing next?
We're going to play Newest Ode. I wrote a tune some years ago called New Ode, or Ode, and then it's the new newer Ode.
The newer Ode.
And then awesome. This is the newest Ode, I think.
Okay.
Whatever you call it, that's what it is.
Great.
I guess.
Looking forward to hearing it. Thank you.
Sure.
And we are back now with the FIU Jazz Faculty Ensemble featuring Gary Campbell on sax, Michael Eckroth on piano, Jamie Owsley on bass, and Ludwig Alfonso on drums. Take it away, guys.
Also, just as a technical point, it's Alfonso. His mother might be listening. Come on. Thank you.
You're listening to the FIU Jazz Faculty Ensemble live in the WDNA Jazz Gallery here on the FIU Music Hour, WDNA 88.9 FM. If you've been meaning to join the WDNA member family, now's the best time during our fall membership drive. Help us reach our goal of $1,000 today. Thank you for your continuous support, and for more information, check out WDNA.org or give us a call at 305-662-8889. We'll be right back after these messages. This week, the FIU School of Music will be hosting the following concert. Friday, October 6th at 7:30 p.m. at the Wertheim Performing Arts Center, the Wertheim School of Music and Performing Arts proudly presents the Recycled Orchestra of Cateura, Paraguay. The Wertheim School of Music is joining forces with the Consulate of Paraguay in Miami and nationwide to partner and present this orchestra to local audiences. For this and many more exciting events, you can find information at FIU.universitytickets.com. And now back to our show featuring the FIU Jazz Faculty Ensemble. So we have time for just a quick one last maybe question for FIU professor and bassist Jamie Owsley. Could you tell us just a little bit about the jazz program at FIU?
Well, yes. We have a thriving jazz program. I also want to mention we have a great concert coming up October 27th, which will feature our faculty, our big band, and a special guest artist, Alex Norris, a wonderful trumpet player and arranger. We'll be playing his music. You know, our audition season starts soon, so people that are interested in applying to FIU, go ahead and start applying to the university. Our first audition is in November. You can find all the information on our website, and you can also contact our champion of FIU, David Fernandez at FIU, and he can help you through any questions you may have about applying to the school. And we also hope to be seeing, you know, going out to some of the high schools this fall.
Great.
We usually do that each year. Another thing I wanted to mention is we're going to have a festival of jazz bands January 20th, where we're going to be inviting Ignacio Baroa to come, and we'll be inviting a lot of high school jazz bands to come play for our faculty, and we'll work with them. And it's like an all-day Saturday type event, so it's pretty fun.
Awesome.
Yeah.
So we've got about time for one more piece just before we close out the show. What are we going to be hearing next?
Sure. So the piece we just played, by the way, was Baubles, Bangles, and Beads, and this is going to be a Sonny Rollins composition called Doxy.
Awesome. Thank you. listening to the FIU Jazz Faculty Ensemble with Professor Gary Campbell on sax, Michael Eckroth on piano, Jamie Owsley on bass, and Ludwig Afonso on drums here on the FIU Music Hour, WDNA 88.9 FM. I've been your host, Ruben Sabando, and along with our executive producer, Dr. Karen Velos, I'd like to thank our FIU graduate student, Anna Josie, WDNA sound and tech wizard, Alex Audrich, producer and live operations instructor, Dr. Rush Spiegel, and the staff of WDNA 88.9 FM for today's broadcast. We'd also like to thank, once again, all of our WDNA listeners, and we ask you to consider making a tax-deductible contribution to support this community. We have a new updated goal of $820, and we'd like to thank everybody that has donated so far. Donate online at WDNA.org or call us before 7 p.m. at 305-662-8889. For more information about our upcoming programs, call 305-348-2896 or like our Facebook and or Instagram page to stay up to date with all of our upcoming performances. Thank you for joining us today, and be sure to join the FIU Music Hour every Tuesday morning from 11 a.m. to noon for more great music. I'd also like to once again thank our guests, the FIU Jazz Faculty Ensemble, for their performance here this morning. And just to close out, what is the last piece we're going to be hearing from you guys today?
Something a little peaceful, a little Skylark with a B-flat pedal for those of you playing at home.
Awesome.
Mm-hmm.